A couple of weeks ago, I started a new project. I want to build myself an electric longboard. Now, please don't get excited, it's not going to be fast. So why did I make this video? Well, I know that a lot of my viewers like to build stuff and are interested in technology. And that will be the story of this video. Building a remote control for an electric longboard and my thoughts about it. My main goal with this project is to make the longboard easy to use, comfortable, and relatively safe. By saying that, the remote control should also be comfortable and safe. I mean, when riding the board, it's constantly in your hand. And it also should fit nicely in my pocket. In short, this is the remote that I built. It's 13 centimeters or 5 inches long, 4 centimeters or 1.6 inch wide, and 2.5 centimeters or 1 inch high. Small enough to fit in my pocket and easy to hold when riding the board. On the top, there is a little power switch. It has 3 LEDs on the front to indicate the remaining battery voltage of the skateboard and the internal battery voltage of the remote. For throttling the board, it has a spring-loaded throttle wheel. Rotating it to the front means power. Rotating it to the back means brake. And the spring will center the wheel, so when I drop the remote, the board will automatically stop. So far, nothing special. But the fun begins when I open the enclosure. As you can see, it's pretty crowded in here. Please note that I bought the enclosure first because it has the right size to be a comfortable remote. After that, I tried to figure out how to fit all the components in there. The most recognizable thing in here is the AA battery that powers the complete remote. It is connected via this power switch to this stack of PCBs here. This stack consists of a voltage step-up booster, an Arduino Pro Mini clone, and a HC05 Bluetooth serial communication module. You can find links for these products on my project website. I'll put a link to this page in the description. The voltage booster converts the battery voltage to 5 volt. This 5 volt is used to power the Arduino and the Bluetooth module. The battery is also connected to an analog input of the Arduino. This way it's possible to measure the battery voltage of the remote control. A full rechargeable battery will give me more than 5 hours of constant use. So that's plenty. If needed, I can always add charging contacts at the bottom of the enclosure. But for now, I will just replace the battery when needed. The generated 5 volt from the voltage booster is pretty noisy, as you can see on the oscilloscope. So there is a low ESR capacitor connected to the 5 volt output of the booster to reduce the noise. The LEDs on the front are simply connected to the digital outputs with a series resistor. The serial port of the Arduino is connected to the Bluetooth module. So all the communication between the remote and the skateboard is done via the serial port of the Omega 328P. When looking at the potentiometer, you probably understand why this was the most time-consuming part. Connecting a potentiometer to the Arduino is simple. Connect the outer pins to ground and plus 5 volt, and connect the wiper to an analog input. Getting it to work mechanically was the hard part. The axle of the potentiometer runs through this custom-made aluminium adapter into a ball bearing on the other side. This makes a throttle wheel run smooth and durable. Figuring out this spring mechanism was a real pain, but finally I decided to make a slot in the aluminium adapter and made a spring from a keyring like this. And as you can see, it works fine. Finally, this is a simplified representation of the complete setup. Another Arduino is communicating with the remote via another paired Bluetooth module. It will also control the motor and measure the battery voltage. With this potentiometer, I can simulate the battery voltage. In the final setup, it will be replaced with the battery voltage of the drive battery. When I power the remote, there is an LED test and the battery status of the remote is shown for 3 seconds. After that, the remote sends a signal to the other Arduino and waits for a confirmation. While waiting, the red LED blinks constantly so I can see that the remote is on. And when I power up the other Arduino, the Bluetooth modules will bind and the battery voltage is shown. With the throttle wheel, I can now increase the duty cycle of the pulse width modulator to power the motor. This is the red line on the oscilloscope. For simplicity and cost reduction, I'm trying to use a brushed motor first. This way I can easily use a powerful FET to drive the motor. I have no idea if it will work, but I will definitely give it a shot. When braking, the pulse that powers the motor is deactivated and another pulse width modulator is activated. This is the yellow line on the oscilloscope. This will drive another FET that will short the motor terminals to create an electric braking force. Again, no idea if it will work, but I will definitely give it a try. If for some reason the communication between the two Bluetooth modules fails, both throttle and brake FETs are disabled, so the board comes to a gentle stop. Before I start working on the motor, I will first practice some more on the board. These things are so sketchy. And that wraps it up for this video. The second part will be about connecting the motor to the skateboard, the electric setup, and hopefully a first successful test ride. Thank you for watching, and please share your thoughts in the comments below.